Hey guys, it's Sam here with your MCO special. How's things going? So, I hope you're having a fun Friday night. And today we are going to be talking about something extra special, which is COVID tests. I'm sure it's something on everyone's minds. Okay, so I'm going to explain a little bit about the COVID tests. Okay, so currently we have two types of COVID tests. Okay, so type 1 is the antigen test, okay, and type 2 is the PCR test. Okay, so what's the difference? What's it all about? So type 1 tests for active infections, whereas type 2 tests for all, I guess, but mainly past. And potentially better. Okay. All right, so I'll go a little bit into how they work. So the antigen, let's start with the antigen test. So basically, they all involve them. It all starts off with you and your nose. Yes, that's handsome man with a manly chin. That's right, because I'm sexist. Okay, right, big enemy eyes, right? There you go, how about that? Right, so what they do is they get this thing called a swab. Okay, it's basically a Q-tip. Okay, don't worry, it's not as hard as it looks. Okay, so, and then they poke it into your nose. Okay, and they wiggle it around a little. So what they're trying to do is they're trying to get some of your booger, you know, is your snot. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Okay, no, I'm just kidding. They're trying to get your cells. Okay, your nose, your nasal cells. Okay, get some cells, and then they'll pop it in a little vial. Okay, with some solution. All right, and basically this solution contains the things that will detect if there is an antigen. Okay, so that's I guess I should talk a little bit about what is an antigen. Okay, so remember this is what COVID looks like, right? COVID. Right, with the little spiky things. Okay, so these spiky things are the antigens. Okay, this is an antigen. Okay, so they're basically things, proteins that they can be bound to, that can be markers. Okay, and then your body makes these things that stick to them, called antibodies. Okay. Okay, so the antigen test is testing the antigen on the virus. Okay, so what that means is it is detecting an active infection, right? Because if you have the little COVID viruses in your nose, then the test will pick it up. Okay, so the pros, let's go into the pros and cons. Okay, so the pros of the antigen test are that it is very fast. Okay, you get a result within like 15 minutes. Okay, it's great. I guess it's not as expensive, so affordable, if that is something people take into consideration. Okay, so the cons is that it is not as accurate, so relatively inaccurate. Okay, why is that? Well, that's because it's only taking a sample from a small section, which is your nose, right? So the virus has to be in those clumps of cells, right? So which technically is, there's actually a lot of cells in there, right? There's thousands and thousands, and it's not just one or two cells, there's lots of cells. And chances are that some of them do have the virus. Yes, that's true, right? But be that as it may, it is still, on the grand scheme of things, not that accurate. Okay, not big enough of a sample size, right? Because the human body is very the big. That is a weird ass looking human. Okay, and the virus is like that big, or got even smaller. Okay, so that's a clump of viruses, right? So they could be hiding anywhere in your body, anywhere. Okay, so of course one of the most likely places is your lungs, or not the lungs. Okay, tongues, you know, or your spine, your nervous system, or your nose. Okay, so yes, they are more likely places, but again, it's not 100%. Okay, and of course, you know, the virus is present at different in different volumes at different times. So if you're still in the incubation period, so that's when the virus is like not doing any real damage or creating any symptoms, and it's not infectious yet. So some viruses can be infectious, contagious during the incubation period. But basically, yeah. So incubation period is when there's still a low viral load, so it may not be detectable then. Okay. Because it's, you know, not present in large volumes. Okay, so it's inaccurate, relatively speaking. Okay, but the good thing is, again, like I said, the pros is it detects an active infection, I guess, you know, which is a good thing, right? You want to know if you have it now. Okay, okay. So the other one is what I call the PCR test. Okay, so PCR stands for polymerase chain reaction, which is a lot of sciencey mumbo jumbo, but basically it is a really cool technique that has revolutionized genetic research. Okay, because what it does, so a little bit sciencey stuff. So polymerase chain reaction has to do with, you know, genetic material, DNA, RNA. Okay, so if you know what DNA, RNA is, all your cells have them. Okay, so you start with a small, very small amount of this DNA, all right, and then you put it in a very fancy little vial, has a clip-on lid, snap. Okay, so imagine you start with like this little bit of DNA here. Okay, start a little bit. Okay, and then what it does is it gets to sit in a nice little warm bath. Oh yeah, right. You know, there's other stuff that they put in. Basically, what it does is it multiplies by like a million billion times or something like that. Okay, so basically by the end of it, you have lots more genetic material. Okay, so the vial is now full of this genetic material. Okay, so the what that means is you know, then if you do a test, you know, you put a little test in there, then if it there is a high chance that you know, the viral genetic material will be in there and it will detect it. Okay, because even if there was a little bit before that it couldn't detect, now it can. So there's lots of it. Okay, so basically the PCR doesn't care whose genetic material, whose DNA it is. It's just gonna replicate everybody's DNA, everybody. So, you know, if you have your DNA and the virus's DNA, it's gonna multiply all of them. Okay, and it becomes legs. Yay! Great. Okay, so the pros and the cons of the PCR. Okay, pro, con. Okay, so the pros are it is very accurate. Okay, because you know, it can detect even if they only get a tiny little bit, you know, you're good to go. Okay, so the cons are it takes a little longer. So it takes longer. Takes about 1 to 2 days at least, and that's if the lab guy is feeling, you know, particularly hardworking. Okay. Do. It's not good. That's not good. Okay. All right. If not, if he's like terribly underworked, as I imagine a lot of them are now, then sorry. You have to wait a little bit longer. Okay. It also, I guess, is a little bit on the expensive side. Okay. A couple hundred. Okay. And thirdly, it picks up pass. So, I mean, that can be a good and a bad thing. So the pros, I suppose, it picks up all infections. Okay, all. So it doesn't matter what stage. But the cons is that it still detects pass infections, right? Because you could have fought off the virus, but the genetic material is, if you still have the DNA in your cells, this test is gonna pick it up. Okay, and you know, so far I think they detected it for at least a few months after, because you know, it's like imagine you have a war, you know, like a war, and you know, there's like leftover tanks and, you know, debris, you know, you've blown up some buildings. Right, and those buildings aren't just gonna clear themselves up. You know, there's gonna be rubble there. You know, broken stuff. The same like in your body, okay? There's going to be leftover bits of the virus smashed everywhere. So the PCR is going to pick it up. Okay, so you could have fought off the COVID. You're fine now, but you're still going to get a positive. Okay, so yeah. We're aware of that, but I think at this point, better safe than sorry. So even if you are past the COVID, you're not infectious, you're not contagious anymore, you know, still take precautions. Okay, so yeah, there you go. There's a little bit of a crash course. Why is everything in pink? Anyway, hope your eyes don't hurt too much from that. Yeah, let me know if I missed anything, if you have anyone new about lead testing. But yeah, I guess, you know, in the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, and have a restful night. Okay? Sam out. Have a good weekend. All right? Don't think about this COVID business. Just stay in. Stay safe. All right? Doodles.